Hello friends, welcome again to the class on motivation theory. Today we discuss one of the classical theories on motivation, theory X and theory Y. We know that Maslow's need hierarchy theory, Herzberg's two factor theory and McGregor's theory X and theory Y are known as classical theories on motivation. We have already discussed the first two theories in the previous classes. In this class we discuss theory X and theory Y. Douglas Murray McGregor formulated theory X and theory Y. He presented this theory in his book titled The Human Side of Enterprise in the year 1960. McGregor was a management professor. Moreover, he was a student of Abraham Maslow. It is believed that McGregor has also taught at the Indian Institute of Management, Calcutta. Theory X and Theory Y explain two aspects of human behavior at working organizations. These two aspects are based on the two different perceptions of managers towards their employees. These are the two different views of managers about employees. One view is somewhat negative and is called theory X, and the other is positive called theory Y. According to McGregor, different managers have different perceptions on employees and they behave in the organization according to these perceptions. These perceptions are formed on the basis of some assumptions. Both theory X and theory Y have different assumptions. Therefore, we need to look at the assumptions of theory X and theory Y. We can start from theory X. You might have seen some teachers who are very strict and serious. Such teachers usually do not allow students to talk in the class or to interact with others. They won't even allow students to laugh. Sometimes they won't allow even to move, and instead always ask questions and give punishments. Always give orders to do this or that. They are not ready to think from the part of students and shout at them without considering the problems and workload of students. Theory X managers are similar to such teachers. We can look at the assumptions of theory X managers. These assumptions explain the perception of theory X managers on the employees. The first assumption is this: an average employee intrinsically does not like work and tries to escape from whenever gets an opportunity. It means that theory X manager believes that the employees are basically lazy people. They don't like to work and they would always prefer to avoid the work. This is what the manager believes. Because of this, such managers behave in a rude manner. They usually shout at employees. The second assumption: since the employees does not want to work, he must be persuaded, compelled, or warned with punishments so as to achieve organizational goals. This is the second assumption of theory X manager. Here, the manager is of the opinion that the employees are lazy and therefore he should persuade and compel them to do the work. Here, the manager believes that if he does not compel them or want them with punishments, they won't do the work. Third assumption: a close supervision is required on the part of managers. We can understand the attitude of manager. The manager has some doubts on the sincerity of employees. He believes that the employees are lazy and therefore strict supervision is required on them. Next assumption: many employees want job security, but they have little or no aspiration and ambition. Here, the manager thinks most of the employees keep an undeserved desire to get job security. He thinks that the employees don't want to work for the organization, but they want to enjoy all benefits. The manager has an opinion that the employees have no right to get promotion and they don't deserve job security because most of the employees have no aspiration or they have no ambition. Because of this feeling, the manager gets irritated and becomes stricter towards them. Another assumption is this. Employees generally dislike responsibilities. The manager thinks that the employees are not interested to take responsibilities and they would prefer to escape from responsibilities as far as possible. Another assumption is this. The employees resist changes. Theory X manager believes that the employees prefer to be safe at their comfort zones and don't like to change. Thus, he thinks that the employees are against changes, improvements, modernization, expansion, and all the growth opportunities of the organization. Next assumption is this. An average employee needs formal direction. Here, the manager underestimates the power, knowledge, and abilities of employees and believes that they don't know what to do, how to do, and when to do. And therefore, regular directions are necessary. Because of this feeling, he tightens the supervision and gives continuous instructions and orders. Theory X managers are highly result-oriented people. They always think about attaining the targets. Most of such persons would be hardworking. They expect such target-oriented hard works from their subordinates also. They strongly believe that laziness would end with bad results. And because of this, they are not ready to compromise with laziness and escapism. Thus, they become furious always. And what happens? This behavior creates some negative impact in the organization. As long as the employees believe that the manager has no trust on their ability and sincerity, it may create some ill feelings among them. This may result into some unhealthy relations. Sometimes, employees may revolt against such managers. As a consequence, manager adopts a more dictatorial style to suppress the employee regressions. Thus, Theory X managers become some more assertive and strict. He becomes authoritarian, who never considers the emotions and feelings of employees. Okay, now we can see how Theory Y managers think. Theory Y managers also keep some assumptions about their employees. Unlike strict and serious teachers, you might have seen some loving, inspiring and motivating teachers. Such teachers believe that the students are hardworking and sincere. And it is the duty of the teacher to support and motivate them for better performance. Usually, most of the teachers are thinking in this way. There are some managers with this style. They are Theory Y managers. Theory Y managers are very positive in their thoughts and actions. We can look at the assumptions of Theory Y managers. The first assumption, employees can perceive their job as relaxing and normal. Such managers think that the employees normally enjoy their work and therefore ready to do it. Managers also believe that the employees would exercise their physical and mental efforts to complete their jobs efficiently. Another assumption is this. The employees do not require threat, external control, and coercion to do the work. Here, manager thinks that the employees can use self-direction and self-control in doing the works. Such managers hope that the organizational objectives can easily be achieved with the dedicated and sincere efforts of employees. Next assumption. If the job is rewarding and satisfying, then it will result in employees' loyalty and commitment to organization. This shows the positive view of the managers on the employees. Such managers are very much confident on employees. Here, the manager thinks that it is his duty to make the job rewarding and satisfying. Then the employees would enjoy in doing it. Such a view can boost up employee-employer relations in the organization. Next assumption is this. An average employee can admit and recognize the responsibility. Unlike theory X, here the managers believe that the employees are willing to take responsibilities and they are ready to cooperate with management for the growth of the organization. Another assumption is this. The employees have skills and abilities and it should be fully utilized. Here the manager thinks that it is his duty to make use of the skills and abilities of the employees for the benefit of the organization. He believes that the employees are skilled and they have the ability to handle the situations in the organization. And it is the manager who should effectively utilize such abilities. In other words, the manager should make use of the creativity and skills of the employees to solve organizational problems. These are the assumptions. Now, what do you think about these two types of managers? We could see that theory X presents a pessimistic view of employees' nature, abilities, and behavior at work, while theory Y presents an optimistic view of the employees' nature and behavior. Before getting into a conclusion, I have some questions on you. Can you say that theory X is highly negative and it is anti-organizational? Can you say that all employees are self-motivated and supervision is not necessary for their effective performance? Do you believe that all of you would study well unless your teachers and parents were compelled to you? No, there are some situations where some kind of compulsion is required. There are some situations where strict supervision is required. There are some situations where punishments and strict orders are required. Theory X and theory Y presents two types of motivation strategies. In general, it is very clear that theory X presents negative motivation and theory Y presents positive motivation. There may be some situations where negative motivation strategies are effective. However, generally, positive motivation strategies have been found effective for long-term success and growth. There are some employees who want to get directions. There are some employees who expect effective supervision and control. Usually, people with low self-esteem and low self-confidence prefer to be directed and controlled by others. Theory X strategies may be effective in such situations. At the same time, people with high self-esteem and self-confidence do not like to be controlled and directed by anybody. Do you remember your school days? You used to get punishments from the teachers for not attending the classes seriously and also for not doing the homework. You might know the teacher enters into the class with a book in one hand and a long cane in the other hand. At that time, you had no such problems and complaints in getting homework and punishments. But now, you are college students and do not tolerate such things. Now you don't like orders and punishments. Now you don't like even the advices. Now your self-esteem has increased. Your confidence has increased. Now you prefer positive motivations. People with self-confidence and esteem cannot tolerate theory X strategies. They prefer theory Y strategies. We need to evaluate theory X and theory Y under these circumstances. We can easily connect this theory with Maslow's need hierarchy theory. If correlate with Maslow's theory, we can see that theory X is based on the assumption that the employees emphasize on the physiological and safety needs. It means that theory X motivation strategies would be more effective with the employees who undergo physiological needs and safety needs. Theory Y is based on the assumption that the social esteem and self-actualization needs dominate the employees. Therefore, theory Y strategies would be effective on those employees who have social esteem and self-actualization needs. However, McGregor views theory Y is more valid and reasonable than theory X. We all believe that theory Y is positive and more significant because it encourages cordial team relations, responsible employees, and harmonious work environment. Theory X has an authoritative style of management. It destroys the sense of teamwork. Such managers kill the sense of the involvement of the employees and demotivate them. Theory X encourages use of tight control and supervision. Such an attitude does not encourage innovation. At the same time, Theory Y provides opportunities to employees to take initiatives and self-direction. It promotes decentralization of authority, teamwork, and participative decision making in an organization. Okay, hope that you could recognize Theory X and Theory Y managers. We can meet in the next class with another topic. Thank you.